Today our topic is analysis and design of machine foundations. So first of all, it's a very common geotechnical topic, and I would like to mention few things that most of the geotechnical and foundation design is based on the soil's behavior under static load. But here we are going to see how the soil behavior under the dynamically loaded machine foundation, and many important structures like turbine, generator, and highly loaded machine components. Most of the time they have complex dynamic loads involved. So the industry machine foundation are very common. You can see few figures of commonly used machine foundation. Most of the time machine foundation provided below the superstructure of a vibrating or rotating machine for installation, and commonly consist of the mass of concrete, heavy mass of concrete. And so from the name itself, all of you can see that the consideration of the static as well as the consideration of the dynamic load are involved. So there are different aspects in the design of machine foundation. So I will discuss in that manner that few aspects for the design as well as how to analyze and what are the applications of machine foundations. So you can see from the figure that different construction related aspects are also involved. It's totally different from the normally as we studied in the geotechnical engineering that shallow foundation or deep foundation. It's totally different from them. So before knowing machine foundation design, need to know the dynamic soil properties. We need to know the what will be the response of the foundation and the dynamic, basically dynamic response, and different units. So in the right side figure, you can see few basic model, basic assumptions of the machine foundation analysis that we use to analyze this heavy concrete mass and whole soil system combiningly in the mass spring dashboard system, which where there is a common dynamic load. The very common assumptions are P equals to P0 sine omega t. Omega is the oscillation of the vibration, and especially dynamic loading, and there will be a repetition of the dynamic loading. The dynamic loading, there are different sorts of dynamic loads. To know the what are the dynamic loads involved from the operation point of view, and that dynamic loads may come due to the unbalanced machinery components, maybe due to some construction activities, say for example pile driving for the high rise building, for the deep dynamic compaction, due to the heavy traffic, and as well as due to the wind and wave actions. So there are lots of things involved in this machine foundation design. So there is very basic structure of the machine foundation, which we call it as a block type machine. So first of all, like we all know that the machine generally consists of that the base of the machine we designed based on the pressure valve or the stress zone. But here the stress zone is not defined, not well defined. It's not like 2.5 to 3.3 times B, means the base of the base width of the foundation. So here the different design aspects will come. So we need to know the different degrees of freedom, different free movement of the foundation. So most commonly there are 6 degrees of freedoms involved in the machine foundation, which are vertical, torsional, rocking, longitudinal, and lateral, as well as swaying machine. So machine and foundation combiningly we need to analyze, as well as the machine components which will be dynamically loaded, as well as the foundation under the dynamic loads, as well as the soil system. So it's a very simple soil structure interaction problem also, you can say. And especially knowing the vibratory soil mass, we need to evaluate that soil properties on that particular zone. So these are few critical aspects of the machine foundation design. Now, like why we need to know the machine foundation design? Here I highlighted that because machine foundation design are two, three aspects. Say for example, we need to know the whether these foundation designs are properly happened, or the range of frequencies, the range of noise produced by the machine foundation, as well as the stability of the machine component itself. So we need to ensure before going for a practical design or practical construction aspects. So you can see that there are three common regions, that optimum, good, as well as poor, based on the frequency, range of frequency. You can divide the based on the range of frequency, or in terms of speed of the machine, we can divide the zone of the vibratory zone in the three different common zone, like optimum, as well as good, as well as poor. So it is common, you can see from the right figure, that commonly we used to model it in terms of spring dashboard model. So we will analyze later that how we'll go for the assumption, because here one of the important portion will be the rotating mass as well as the hydrodynamic coupling. So here two, three things will involve, as well as like first of all, we need to ensure the static loading. It must be safe under the static load. So, all of we know that the for the static, under the static load, that we have foundation design, like two main criteria. One is the bearing capacity, another is settlement criteria. Those things must be satisfied. Other than these few important things we need to ensure. So this is another aspect of the machine foundation design, that how to control that vibration. Because suppose one industrial area, there are vibration we have designed. So due to that vibration, the surrounding building, surrounding residential or any sensitive equipment, that must not be damaged. So for that thing, we need to ensure that the vibration control devices must be installed in the foundation. So it must be in terms of noise barrier, in terms of the human vibration also we need to control. Vibration control system also we need to design in addition to machine foundation design. So we need to know the vibration limits. So basic things are like the, we need to know that what are the dynamic loads, what will be the amplitude, frequency. So based on that thing, first of all, we need to know the vibration limits, because if we want to control, if we want to mitigate or screen some vibration, before that we need to know what will be the free field or the vibration response of the foundation without any control device. So there are a common mode of vibration isolator, which is multi-layer rubber isolator, as well as base isolator. Other than this, there are lots of vibration isolators are there for machine foundation. For example, waste plastics also used as the layer, as well as there are new sustainable techniques, new sustainable methodologies are also proposed in recent times. We'll see in detail in next slide. That this is one example I have given, that for the which is the common, like most common, most used technology. It is the application of the geosynthetic in the foundation. So geosynthetics are also used for the foundation, this machine foundation design, or as well as machine foundation vibration mitigation. So it is one common experimental setup I am showing here, that under the oscillator and the loading plate, how at the reinforced subgrade we are providing that the geosynthetics that I will mention, that geosynthetics are there are lots of classification, which may be geosail, which may be geofoam, which may be geogrid. So based on that thing, that here most commonly used technology are geosail, because of the confinement also, because of the material properties also. So before the choosing of any control device or any control materials, we need to know the soil properties as well as the load, incoming loads. Based on that thing, we will design that geosynthetic or any control system also. So this is one example I have shown. So here one of the important thing involved, that how we'll measure the vibration. So maybe before measuring vibration, we need to know the accuracy level, we need to know the ranges. So sensor is important role to play here. So the accuracy of the sensor, the calibration of the sensor, and it is very, very costly devices. All the devices, for example, this sensor arrangement, where to place the sensor, where will be the vibration critical. So all those things we need to know before the, it's not like at the base of the footing only we are taking, there will be some critical zone. So again, just few slides ago I mentioned that here the zone pressure valve is not like the shallow foundation or the normal deep foundation design. Here pressure valve will be different. So here one example, this I've taken from one recently published research paper, that the application of the geo cell at the base of the foundation. So here also people have designed first for the static load, then they have used that I was mentioning that rubber soil mixture in between the geo cell to mitigate the vibration, to reinforce the vibration coming from the system. So foundation mitigation as well as the strengthening of the foundation due to the incoming vibratory loads, the aspects we need to take care in the machine foundation design. So one of the common test for the this measuring vibration, for measuring the dynamic response, is known as the block vibration test, which has a huge application in the oil and gas industry as well as the nuclear power plant. It's a kind of field measurement, of course, like we can't do all those things inside the laboratory. We can evaluate dynamic properties in the laboratory test, small scale laboratory test based on the strain level. But to know the exact dynamic response, we need to go for the block vibration test, which is a very simple test for the machine foundation. So we first of all we need to evaluate the soil stratum, level layer of the soil up to bedrock depth, because during the machine foundation design, seismic potential evaluation is also important thing. So dynamic response of the machine foundation, firstly we need to cast that foundation and typical model foundation, and then we need to put the vibratory load, and based on the available sensor, based on the level of the vibration, we need to capture the vibration. So here one of the block vibration test I am showing here, and there is a few setup, how to complete set of the setup of the block vibration test. Let's see, I was mentioning that because here vibration level, it at the surface, just 0.5 meter below the surface, based on the soil level it will be different. So most commonly used technique is the used to dig some peat based on the model dimension of the foundation. So on that peat, this left figure I am showing here, the rotating mass component. So here you can see that it is a rotating mass. So both the things, two masses will rotate to produce the vibration on the underneath foundation. So here each and every block, each and every joints are important, because the vibration must be properly ensured, that vibration must pass through this foundation to the soil system. So you can see that there is a complete setup of the foundation system. So each and every joints has important role, because otherwise we will the actual level of the vibration will not be measure. And similarly for the big other kind of foundation, like generator for the oil or the nuclear power plant, like this type of setup first need to prepare in the field lab or the model testing lab, then only we can go for the actual construction of the machine foundation. So here is a very important role of the oscillator as well as the each and every component. All of you can understand from the figure itself as well as the importance of the study itself. So another important thing we need to ensure, that generally these machine foundations are very closely spaced industrial area, and it's a very huge mass of concrete we need to place. So closely spaced machine foundation have important role. Interference effect, that means the effect of the one foundation on the other foundation, nearby another foundation. Generally we used to call it active and the passive footing. Active footing means which foundation is vibratory active and nearby another foundation. So these things also we need to evaluate. So here I am trying to mention you that the what are the important aspects before. It is not like a shallow foundation we are designing only for the static load, the interference effect is not that much predominant. So for the shallow foundation design, we need to ensure just that certain amount of the spacing, that's all. But here we need to ensure the incoming vibration also, it must satisfy not only the static normal cases, not of static spacing as well as the static depth due to the static loading also. So this is, you can see there's another complete set of that block vibration test I am showing here. This is some result from the block vibration test. So how we used to ensure, because one of the important thing is that what are the dynamic load frequency and the natural frequency of the soil. So if both the things are matching, then there will be resonance. So we need to satisfy the resonance criteria. It should not be far away whom the resonance or far below from the resonance. So both the things, all of you can see from the figure that the top peaks are like towards infinity. That is the resonance criteria for the different type of footing. So different type of eccentric mass. So I am another important term I am here mentioning, eccentric mass, because we are considering two different rotating mass. So there will be some eccentricity. So as an equivalent mass, we need to evaluate the eccentric mass value. Both the things, all are different things, not only displacement as well as the acceleration is also important. So we need to evaluate, we need to take care of all these things before designing machine foundation in the field. But for the big area or the big oil and gas industry I mentioned, their machine foundations are not only the concrete mass, there will be the pile supported by the mass. So that is also interesting things to design, that how that machine foundation supported by the piles and what will be the installation process. Here I am not mentioning till now that the installation process or the practical aspects. So that will be important, that how the driven pile or the boat pile, how we need to install the pile in the field depends on the bedrock level as well as the, first of all, we need to evaluate the dynamic properties of the soil also. So you can see from that, for the oil and gas industry, that for the offshore structure, what are the different application of the machine foundation? That offshore wind turbine is vast application of the machine foundation, that piles, design of the pile. So based on the seabed level, so we need to evaluate the what type of pile we are going for. So it will be either monopile or maybe very deep pile. So based on that thing, we need to choose the material properties also, because another important thing here will be in the, for the offshore structure, there will be the effect of the wind effect as well as the water waves. So both the things, both the loads we need to take care of, not only simple static load. So both are dynamic, both types of load are dynamic in nature, as well as the bedrock will be the nearer, there will be high chances of the earthquake or any tsunami type of event, any other dynamic activities nearby seashore. So there are construction, there are different construction challenges, because first of all, that submerged condition. So I am just a little bit more focusing on that, the offshore structure, because nowadays offshore structure has huge applications of this machine foundation design, because a dynamic properties evaluation, especially in the submerged condition, there is no straightforward formula. It's not like effective stress, just we are evaluating effective value of the soil parameter. So we need to consider several small aspects before designing. For example, we can do it numerically, we can do it field, but we need to evaluate the properties, because this all properties are simultaneously it will be used. So one property's mistake mean that next potential will be erroneous value will come. As I was mentioning, that the both wind and the water effect for the offshore structures, both wind and water effect will be predominant. So machine foundation in the oil and gas industry, mostly for the deep foundation of the turbine, generally jacketed platforms are made. On the above of the jacket platform, that machine foundation is to place. And this offshore wind turbine also, that we need to first fix the operating frequency based on the wind speed, as well as the based on the wave speed also, we need to evaluate the lateral thrust on the foundation. So lateral stability aspect will be also important thing. And generally, also I mentioned that the interference effect, because they're generally these offshore wind turbines are very closely spaced. So what are the different disciplines involved in this machine foundation design? So you can see that there is the very basic things of the soil dynamics, which consists of the mass spring dashboard system, as well as the EHS theory. EHS theory means that most of the soil dynamics theories are based on the elastic half space theory. Soil has been modeled as the elastic half space material, as well as the different modes of vibration. So generally, for the shallow foundation or the deep foundation, we used to consider the vertical mode of the vibration only. But here rocking mode also, because you can easily correlate that when wind water effect will come, wind effect will come, there will be huge chance of the torsion, huge chance of the rocking mode. So different modes of factor of safety for the different modes we need to evaluate. So here one of the important thing will be the wave propagation, because we are due to the vibratory mode, there will be generation of the different type of waves based on the soil, based on the water table level. So waves will be different. So based on the nature of the waves, we need to design the machine foundation accordingly, because one machine foundation at the ground surface and another machine foundation is little bit in the undiluted level. So we need to evaluate the different aspect like this. So construction aspects are also important thing, because as I was mentioning that during the construction, particularly all these vibratory components, machinery components, foundation mass placement, all those aspects will be critical, as well as foundation dynamics will be critical, because here the bearing capacity will not be like a static bearing capacity. All of which studied like Mayerhoff bearing capacity, the Jaggi's bearing capacity theory, but here the bearing capacity will be the dynamic bearing capacity. So it is little bit different from the classical theory of the bearing capacity, as well as for the deep foundation, which is very huge application for the oil and the gas industry. We need to take care of all those aspects just I mentioned, as well as vibration isolation or vibration screening point of view. If suppose we need to go for higher frequency of the vibration, because machine foundations are totally depends on the industrial application, which type of application, say for example heavy speed engines we are providing, so then there will be the high, based on the high speed, based on the speed range, frequency range, we need to go for the screening, we need to go for the vibration control. So obviously one of the important thing is the project cost. We should not go for the very high cost material, say for example rubber at the bearing. So that is not very cost easy economical approach. So there are lots of different approaches, say for example providing sandbags nearby foundation to absorb the incoming vibration, to go for more sustainable methodology. So there are lots of methodologies are there, sustainability aspect as well as the cost aspect. So all these things are involved in the machine foundation design. So all of you can understand that there is like huge branches of like lots of branches of geotechnical engineering, as well as the dynamics, simple, not only soil dynamics, structural dynamics are also involved, as well as the basic theory of the vibration, which is not specifically civil engineering topic, like it's mechanical engineering topic, vibration related things are also involved. So another important thing I want to mention that, the for example settlement bearing capacity I was saying, so settlement also will change due to the dynamic load. It will be not like static settlement. We cannot evaluate like just like a consolidation settlement or the immediate settlement. So under the dynamic load we need to evaluate the settlement value, as well as the potential for the soil or the liquefaction, for example lateral earth pressure analysis, all the basic soil mechanics theory, for example lateral earth pressure theory, for example this liquefaction theory, all those things will be modified according to these modes of vibration. So liquefaction potential also important things for in this machine foundation design. And so what is the Indian scenario of the machine foundation design? So there are four common Indian standard codes are there, four part, IS 2974, design and construction of the machine foundation. They are divided, it is very old, you can see from the year I mentioned here, it is the last revision 82, 80, 79, 87. So for the recent times, say for example, there are no mention in the for the this oil and the offshore machine foundation. So these are very common machine, for the reciprocating machine, impact type of machine, rotary type of machine, and hammer, forging hammer or impact machineries. So all these are very common machinery, very simple machines. So for this offshore wind turbine, there is no specific code, Indian code for the offshore wind turbine. Say for example, that will be the importance of the pipeline network also, because generally oil refinery foundation, there will be importance of the pipelines also. So all those things simultaneously we need to take care during the machine foundation design. So current Indian standards only focused on this very basic rotating mass type, as well as the reciprocating mass type machines, which are very common old machine for the very simple industrial structures. But for the oil refinery, offshore and other important nuclear power plant also, so those foundations designs are not well standardized till now, till yet in Indian scenario. So here I am showing some practical example of the some upstream offshore as well as the onshore machine foundation. In the Middle East, there is some many companies are there. They are working on the machine foundation. For example, Fenchurch, Michelson. It is one common company for the oil industry. You can see the what we were mentioning, that importance of the wind as well as the incoming waves. DNVGL, there is one another company on the turbine and offshore foundations. You can see that the how closely these wind turbines are placed and the amount of waves coming and rotating frequency of the these wind turbines are also very high. So there we need to analyze critically the machine foundation design. We need to very clear about the machine foundation theory, all the disciplines already I mentioned. Another company is there, the GeoQIP Marine. Generally, marine soil are also different. So another important thing is the marine, how the soil types will be varied in the marine environment. For example, the scour assessment, for example, geohazard assessment, that already I mentioned the hazard. There may be different hazardous event. So generally, machine foundations supported by the piles are very common in the offshore turbine. So there will be the pull-out resistance. That will be also important. So all of you can understand that in the submerged conditions, soil at the seabed, soil properties will be different. So design of the pile foundation will also alter. And especially the tip bearing resistance of the soil of the pile at the soil bottom. So it will be, we need to evaluate the pile capacity. So generally here normal, it's not like high rise building that just like we will evaluate through the pile integrity test. We will go for the normal standardized formula. So here pile load carrying capacity will be different. Similarly for the foundation block design, for example, the mass of concrete design, that will also different. We need to design, go for the much more stronger reinforcement in the foundation. So the currently, recently, lots of new methodologies, new materials have been developed for this, for the concrete block also, for as well as the supported pile foundation also. So this is a very basic theory, DPST. So design, processing, sampling, and testing. So I'll divide this thing into design means like I'm going for the, what will be the mid design, what will be the depth of the foundation, what will be the materials. And processing means what will be the installation process, what will be the, how we'll maintain it, because during the design life we need to maintain the foundation also, as well as the casting of the foundation. And sampling means like what will be the site specific design, because based on the available, say for example somewhere marine clay is available, somewhere silty sand is available, so based on the site specific thing, design will alter. Similarly, sensor control, already we were discussing that the sensor importance of the vibration devices, how we will control the vibration, that is also important. Similarly, for the testing, you mentioned the vibration testing, there will be the dynamic response, so vibration control evaluation. So you can understand that before designing for this offshore turbine or nuclear power plant, we need to evaluate all those things, all these four things in very critically we need to evaluate, because all terminology involves lots of dependent things, because it's not only one machine foundation we are going to provide. There will be the huge like group of machine foundation, just like group of piles. So before designing it, we need to evaluate all those things, and there will be different frequency of load also. And in past, there are lots of failure of the machine foundation, and lots of failure due to dynamic loads have happened. So we need to evaluate this. Recent development happened, and very recent times, currently ongoing research is going on, and in future also there are huge scope and very gray areas are there, especially for the interference effect. I already mentioned that for the industrial machine, for the offshore monopiles. Monopiles, I already told you that monopiles are especially for the shorter length pile. It's not, it's similar to the very large diameter deep pile. So monopiles design also important. Similarly, application of the geosynthetics, because of course we'll go for the more cost effective solution, more economic solution. So similarly, like seismic isolator, noise control, as well as different other sustainable methodologies are options are there. So lots of researches are going on. Similarly for the oil and the gas industry, because there will be already mentioned hydrodynamic behavior. So coupled behavior, this evaluation of this behavior and frequency control test, because all are frequency we are. So here we are not still mentioning about the earthquake, because seismic evaluation is also important. And especially what will be the soil behavior, that is also not, it's well defined, because normally soil dynamic theory, it's based on the elastic half space theory, it's simple linear elastic law. So here under the, this hydrodynamic coupling behavior, soil linear elastic theory will not valid. Even for the last slide, we few slides ago we mentioned that the wave propagation theory, that is also completely based on the linear elastic law. So here also that material will not behave like linear elastically. So what will be the material behavior, soil behavior? So we need to analyze, we need to evaluate also. So here it is not totally, theory will be not based on the Hooke's law of elasticity, sigma equals to E epsilon. So here the material constitutive behavior will be totally different. So we need to evaluate the constitutive laws. Similarly, another important aspect I mentioned that also, that pipeline geotechnique, because based on the machine weight, based on the strain level, strain development, we need to design for the surrounding machinery components also. Another one part is the pipeline. So pipeline geotechnique has also important role to play. Few important machine foundation I am showing here, that I was always already mentioned that what is the monopile, what is the jacketed foundation, what is the floating structure. So it's totally based on the availability of the sea bedrock. So we need to evaluate the scour potential also, because at the bed of the foundation there will be the scour, there will be the erosion. So erosion protection also we need to take care. So you can see it's totally based on the depth of the foundation, depth of the bedrock or seabed, as well as that foundation, like of the machinery components. So both the things are important. So before we are going to evaluate the dynamic response of the machine foundation, we need to know things very critically. Actually, we need to analyze, we need to the output or the response of the foundation, that how these things are behaved. After that only we can go for the practical things, because there are huge chances of the accident or catastrophic failure of the this type of geotechnical structures. So another thing is, like here you can say that the importance of the water level, because water level is playing very important role. Because water level depth at the less than 60 meters, more than 60 meters, there will be the change in the design. Generally, monopiles are very common, already many people have used. Similarly, caisson piles are also used. Similarly, gravity base, tripods, even the tension leg plates are also used. So all these things, designs are very common, but challenges are different, because it's already I mentioned it that the site specific, very much site specific, there will be lots of challenges for the design of this machine foundation. So another important thing involved in this machine foundation design, which is very kind of interdisciplinary thing, that is energy geotechnique. So energy stored. So ultimately, the objective of the wind turbine is to store the energy, wind power. We need to convert the wind turbine, and we need to use in terms of different electricity or in the battery. So optimizing the grid. So you can see that the energy geotechnique, so ultimately under and the energy principle, how soil is behaving. So up to that level, like we mostly used to analyze geotechnical things in terms of stress strain theory. We used to evaluate either displacement or either the stress value. But here we need to evaluate the energy potential of the structure. So here geotechnical structure has different role to play. So we need to evaluate the in terms of energy principle. So you can understand that the here thermodynamic things also will also involve, because of that energy storage, because the thermodynamic theory will also involve in this theory. So earthquake also important role to play. So different basic theory first, with lots of basic theories as well as the advanced theories are also involved in this machine foundation design. I hope like you'll end in this after this thing.